I really expect that brain preservation, it is a solvable problem and it will be solved within the next decade. I think it will be absolutely solved within the next decade, that we will be able to preserve an entire human brain at the synaptic level, and that more and more neuroscience evidence will convince people that that really is who we are. My name is Kenneth Hayworth. I have a PhD in neuroscience. I currently am working at Howard Hughes Medical Institute, developing machines and techniques for mapping brain tissue at the nanometer scale, so that you can take a look at a piece of brain tissue and see all of the circuitry within it, all of the connections between neurons. I am also a futurist, a transhumanist, whatever you want to call it, and I am president of the Brain Preservation Foundation, an organization that is dedicated to get more scientific research into perfecting things like cryonics and cryonics alternatives. It's clear from my point of view that current cryonics techniques are not able to simply be reversible. They are something that would take very, very advanced technology. And so the real question is the essence of who we are preserved so that very advanced technology can undo the damage that we know is occurring? I want to know what my brain is going to look like if I have to undergo one of these procedures. And there are some images out there from electron microscopes of pieces of brain tissue, but very few. And there's no systematic evidence that's in the scientific literature that says if you undergo this particular procedure, your brain will be preserved at this level. I talked to the researchers that are really pushing forward these techniques, and they are doing a fantastic job with their limited amount of resources and the fact that the world seemingly is against them doing anything. But given all of that, they have not been able to demonstrate that the synaptic organization of the brain is preserved by these current techniques. And so I as a skeptic and a scientist, really have to look at that and say, you've got to do a better job, because this is something that is a life or death issue. So the thing that my organization has done is raised $100,000, which is not a very large amount of money, but $100,000 for a prize that basically said, okay, if the cryonics community or any other can demonstrate that an entire large mammal brain can be preserved at this synaptic level, which neuroscience tells us is encoding our identity, if they can reach that milestone, they will win this prize. Now, the prize is not about money. The prize is all about credibility, because in the minds of the cryonics skeptics, really the brain is turned into mush. And that's not exactly true. In the minds of advocates, it seems like there's an opposite type of enthusiasm for, oh, we don't know that it works, but it probably works. And you know, let's not look too deeply into it, because we might see stuff that we don't want to see. We're trying to find a milestone where we can get advocates and skeptics to meet in the middle, and that opens up a dialogue. And so, for instance, Michael Shermer, very big skeptic, he's on our board of advisors. Why is he on our board of advisors? Because he's here to keep us honest. He's here to make sure that I'm not going to look with rose-colored glasses at the images that I see and say, oh, that's got to be because I really want it to be true. We've got a bunch of other scientists that are there to keep us skeptical, to make sure that that milestone is a real milestone, so that when it is met, the skeptics will have already signed off on it. A revolution and help people accept brain preservation.